Baba Yaga, motherfucker. Bro, I forgot that I need this if I'm gonna give people their proper credit. This is a movie all about teamwork and rules and structure, and the stunt team and the choreographers and the cinematographers all play a big part in that. See, Opera GX agrees. John Wick Chapter 4 is directed by the director of the last three John Wick movies, the great Chad Stahelski, who I'm just realizing looks a lot like Jason Isaacs. And it again stars Keanu Reeves as the boogeyman, the most creative killer ever. And we love him for it. I love him for it. I love these movies, man. Just as a prerequisite to this review, before anybody asks, no, I am not high this time. I'm a responsible citizen. I can control it. And I'm out of gummies, so. As promised at the end of John Wick Chapter 3 Parabellum, John himself is on the war path against the High Table. He is aiming to take them down and earn his freedom, and he finds a very tactical way to do that in the form of challenging a very high-ranking and ambitious member of the High Table to a duel to the death at sunrise. But this high-ranking table member, the Mark, is determined to make sure John does not meet his appointment, and so he sends an army of assassins after Baba Yaga, and here's Chapter 4, baby. Okay, so how do I put my thoughts on this movie? Oh, God. Fuck. I'm sorry, I can't get close to the table. My dick's too hard from seeing this. Fucking damn it, I love this movie. This is incredible. I know a lot of insanely good reviews have been dropping about this movie, but if anything, they undersell how good it is. If you have heard any great things about this movie at all, believe it and assume it's even better. This is easily the best movie of 2023 so far. It's easily the best of the John Wick sequels, and I do not say this lightly, it is even better than the first John Wick movie. That is right, we now have the new best film in the entire John Wick franchise. It has me so fired up, I'm getting my silly putty out, guys. Give me just a second. It's incredible. It is once again just a magnificent action movie with very good world building and very good characters and plot. And while all of the story elements of this movie play their part very well, they are ultimately the excuse for the action. And you know, that's why we love John Wick. That's why we come back to see the movies. I myself being one of those people, and they really up the ante on that excuse here. Most of every second in the movie, John Wick is in a fight, and the movie is always coming up with some excuse to get him into a fight in the best way possible. John Wick could find a penny on the street and get into a death match with an entire mob of brawlers over the goddamn penny, and it's every bit as epic as it sounds. John himself, the character, brings back everything you loved about him in the previous movies, including just the creativity and the brutality of all of these kills. I don't want to give away too much. I don't want to give away the surprise. You got to savor it when it comes. Even for John Wick standards, the kills in this movie are so creative. He is killing people with knives, with guns, with nunchucks, with walls.
But hey, Crispy, he's most famous for killing three guys with a pencil, right? Did we get anything of that quality?
Fuck yeah, he does.
And of course, Keanu himself. Good God, when he came back for these movies. Okay, I unfortunately had to see the first movie on DVD at a friend's house because, and just for the record, this was actually back during the days where I was training to be a stuntman. Could have trained harder, honestly, but maybe I made the wrong choice quitting when I did, but I just kind of decided it wasn't something for me. Mad shout out to Team Red Pro and DC Stunt Coalition. But anyway, I thought that John Wick looked like, you know, something you would watch on an old TiVo. You know, it first came out when Keanu was still kind of considered a joke. He was the whoa guy, and that was it. But I had so many people, including my friends in these aforementioned stunt groups, tell me that the first John Wick was actually really good. The action was really good. And you know, my response, of course, was Keanu Reeves is the starring actor. And everyone told me, yeah, he's incredible too. He's actually excellent in these movies. And I didn't believe them until it was too late and it was out of theaters. I was such a sucker back then. But once again, as usual, Keanu is just excellent as John Wick. He really just hit the ground running back into his career when he came back in the John Wick movies, man. And if anything, he probably ups his game in this movie because I'm pretty sure he only has like 10 lines in this entire movie. Like, as usual, John Wick is a man of few words. But his delivery, he can turn like a simple yeah, like it's something like that. He can make it seem like an entire monologue. It's incredible. The man is really good at creating this character whose actions speak much louder than his words. And as I'm sure a lot of people have said, and I myself am saying right now, I just don't see anybody else being able to play John Wick. I don't see the franchise carrying on without Keanu Reeves. He is just the core of this franchise in so many ways.
Hi, I'm Crispy from the future, and I forgot to say this in my review last night, but this is pretty important. One thing I also really love about Keanu's performance as John Wick, he embodies the wear and the tear of the character. You can tell that this is a guy who is not in his prime, but he's still kicking ass in him, and he can also like take as much as he dishes out, and that feels incredible. And it stops him from being the sort of like, you know, invincible Arnold Schwarzenegger type hero he might otherwise be if he were played by a different actor who wouldn't be able to embody that as well.
But I think that without him, I would not have had as much fun with this movie as I did. And believe me, I was having so much fun every second of it. Like, the experience is indescribable. I don't think I've ever quite seen a movie like this. But of course, with a great main character for an action film should come a lot of great supporting characters as well. And this movie has some great supporting characters, both new and returning. I've especially got to give mad props to Donnie Yen as Kane. I cannot even describe the hype that I felt when I found out that he was going to be in this movie. Donnie Yen is one of my favorite action film actors. I've been a fan of his, honestly, since I saw him in Shanghai Nights when I was a kid. And of course, I loved him in the Ip Man movies, and once again, just like in Rogue One, where, and by the way, I loved him in that movie as well, of course, he comes to this movie as a blind badass who was once an associate and friend of John Wick, still kind of is, but is put on a collision course with the guy. He is contracted to kill him, and he stands to lose a lot if he does not succeed in the task. But even then, he still kind of goes back and forth in the movie between being his friend again and being back to the guy hunting him down for the sake of the contract because of the way their profession works. Donnie Yen gives him so many incredible fight scenes, but Kane himself is a very charming, very likable character, and I thought he was a great addition to the cast. Another standout performance is Shamir Anderson as the Tracker, or as he comes to be called later in the movie, Mr. Nobody. Kane is a bit of a wild card, but this guy is the real wild card of the movie, and he's all the cooler for it. He, like pretty much everybody else in this movie, wants to kill John Wick, but he's waiting for the right moment to do it. He's in it for the money, and he's waiting for the price on John's head to go up high enough so that the kill is worth it, and he's always renegotiating the terms. He's always playing all the different sides to make sure that he can get the most out of this so that he can come out on top. And of course, in any John Wick movie, you've got to have the badass attack dog. He is the owner of said badass attack dog in this movie. That is him. I would not be surprised if he came back for a spinoff. Frankly, a lot of his presence in the movie does kind of feel like it's setting him up for a spinoff, but I mean that in a really good way because, again, he's such a cool character, and I would really love to see a spinoff with him in it. Bill Skarsgård as the villain. He is a standout, largely because of Bill Skarsgård's performance. The John Wick franchise has always been a very good-looking franchise, very pleasant to look at, very beautiful, and also very cultured. It takes place in locations like art museums, opera houses, exotic hotels, and exotic locations even, and believe me, we'll get to those later.
Hi, it's Crispy from the future again, and I forgot to say this, but like the scope of everywhere they go in this movie and just the exotic beauty of the locations and the sets, it feels like, you know, it's very evocative of James Bond. So anybody watching this movie who's a Bond fan, you're gonna love the feel of it.
And the Marquis, Skarsgård's character, makes it very clear that he is able to enjoy the best of this, the finest of the finer things in life. He always has the best suits on, he'll always surround himself with the best artwork, and he'll be able to debate you about what that artwork means. He's a character of a lot of culture, but that abundance of culture just highlights the character's lack of class. He's a snake of a man who is really nothing without his wealth and his resources, and he knows it. He's not a fighter, so he goes and sends all of these other men to kill John Wick for him. The man's a coward, basically. And that is kind of disappointing. I was kind of hoping for a main villain who we could look at and be like, oh my god, this dude alone is a menace. John has got his work cut the fuck out for him. But he was still a good villain. He had some cool lines. One point in the movie, he calls John a ghost in search of his graveyard. I personally think that is one of the best lines in the movie. And again, Skarsgård just does such a good job of making him ooze with arrogance, and he really makes you want to see this guy go down in a way that we haven't wanted any John Wick villain gone since Joseph from the first movie. Yeah, that's right, he's on the same level as the guy who shot the puppy. And of course, we got the returning cast as well. Hiroyuki Sanada is also in this movie, and as usual, he is such a badass. I feel like I'm using the word badass a lot in this review. It's fitting, though. It really is. And of course, I gotta mention the returning cast as well. Winston, as usual, is such a kick-ass character. He's always so much fun to watch whenever he's on screen. Lawrence Fishburne returns as the Bowery King, and once again, he's a standout as well. But it's not a John Wick without the action, and the action in this movie, okay, the action choreography in this movie might be some of the best I've seen in any movie, period. I mean, they have do so many stunts with cars, they have this fight in a museum portion of a hotel, and they have two very good sequences involving staircases. One of them you might know about. It was memed on Instagram, Critical talked about it. It features a guy falling down a set of escalator steps and just bouncing, and just the work they put into that. I mean, that's just one example of what you see in John Wick 4. I mean, that really makes you appreciate what stunt workers do. I mean, like, they are like 90% of the backbone of the industry that is action filmmaking, and frankly, they don't get half the credit that they should get. The stunt team in this movie is incredible. The choreographers are incredible. The cinematographers are incredible. They have a scene where John is fighting and killing a bunch of guys using only a pair of nunchucks and a handgun. You have a scene in the movie where he's fighting a bunch of people in ongoing traffic, killing them with the cars. But there is one scene in particular that I have to mention that has got to be one of the top 10 best scenes I have ever seen in any action movie, period. Period. John ends up in an abandoned apartment, and he is fighting a bunch of guys, and he gets his hands on, of all things, a dragon's breath shotgun, and he is just tearing people apart with it and setting them on fire at the same time. And they do an overhead shot where they're following him through the rooms like it's a video game. The whole movie plays out like a video game, actually. It's an incredible scene, and as usual, John is just going all out with the kills. He's like triple tapping people this time. You really feel the rage that this guy has. I mean, you felt it at the end of John Wick 3, and he carries it full throttle into this movie. Like, John has probably never, ever been more pissed at anyone for anything. There's a reason the John Wick franchise is one of my favorite movie franchises out there. When you think of it, you just think quality. You think a thing of beauty. And I think a lot of that is because these movies have just gotten better and better and better with each iteration of just looking really good. And this movie takes it to a whole other level. They film this movie in so many beautiful locations. You have John Wick in Osaka, and then you have him in Berlin, and then you have him in France. John Wick up to this point has usually been a crime noir drama, but this time it feels like a crime noir adventure. It feels like its very own, very new genre, this entire movie. Again, even for John Wick standards, it just takes the uniqueness of the whole thing to a whole other level. It sets up the circumstances of the John Wick universe in a way that feels otherworldly but also believable. There are rules, there's a system, there's a code of honor and ethics, and that's always been what's made these movies special. The people making the John Wick movies operate on a very strict set of rules, and the characters in these movies operate on very strict sets of rules as well. And of course, you have the very compelling compare-contrast of genuine honor versus deals to the devil, if you will. And it's still a beautiful dichotomy. But at the end of the day, all this really is an excuse for action. Borderline endless action following a guy who is just really pissed off and taking it out in the most epic revenge fantasy ever. The score of this movie is great too. They bring back songs from the old movies, they remix them. It's just, they do so many new things with the soundtrack and it's incredible. As far as action film franchises go, John Wick is just up there. It's just like one of the greats. It's John Wick and Mission Impossible. It's just, those are the two that are up there that hold the stakes. They are just borderline impossibly good. Between Tom Cruise doing so much of the work himself and doing all these insane stunts, to just the beyond words incredible quality of everything that is put into the John Wick franchise by everyone involved. It's just phenomenal. It's really phenomenal. Now, I really don't want to make it sound like I didn't have issues with this movie, because the movie's not perfect. I do have some thoughts. The John Wick movies usually require a certain suspension of disbelief, if you will. Even for John Wick standards, this movie does require quite a bit of that. They have a fight scene in a club where John is straight up just chopping people to bits with a hatchet, and everybody is dancing around the fight scene. But the thing is, you have people looking, you have people clearly seeing what's going on, and they keep dancing like nothing's happening. Now, eventually later on in the fight scene, they do start fleeing the club, but for a completely unrelated thing. And in fact, it's around the denouement of the fight, so it kind of feels like they're running out of there in a hurry for nothing. And as much as I love the car fight scene, you have the same thing going on there. Like, these people are firing guns and shooting at each other in the middle of traffic, and these cars are still going. It's moments like that where you gotta suspend your disbelief, but other than that, I can't really think of any real problem I have with this movie. It's borderline perfect, and I really don't say that about a lot of movies. Pulling this movie out of the oven, I can very happily say that this movie is 96% crispy. An entree unlike any you will ever have, ever. Definitely going in the Blu-ray collection when it comes out. I have to see this movie again. I have to. I will die to see this movie again. This movie's really good, guys. This movie's really good. Hope you guys enjoyed this review. If you did, please make sure to like, share, subscribe. Come join the Crispy Kingdom. We are all royals here. I also have a gaming channel. I have a Twitch. I have a Clip channel. Link is also down below for the Global Nerds podcast and other projects that I am a part of, such as Power Rangers Unworthy, Power Rangers Western Strike, Power Rangers Digital Beast. I'm in a lot of Power Rangers stuff, I know. And the most recent addition to my filmmaking resume, a short movie that I made with some friends of mine titled One Heart. This has been real crispy. And that's it. The crisp is spoken. Take care.